All right, No Jumper, coolest podcast in the world. You guys never been on a podcast before?
No.
No? I was watching interviews with you when you were like 17, Phil, from Dertbag.
Yeah, I was super young.
Are those embarrassing, still having those out in the world?
No, it's cool because those get like the most love.
Right.
But yeah, it's a little, I don't watch them.
Yeah.
I don't like really look at my old shit.
But do people hit you up and they like expect you to be that same dude that you were back then? But, and it's your birthday, so this is pretty exciting. You just turned 21.
Yeah, yeah. It's really dope.
Turn up. So who's this year left? You want to introduce me?
Posh God and Tub God.
Posh God and Tub God. It's very out of the ordinary for a bunch of white guys to take on God as their suffix. Or as their last name, I guess, as the case would be.
I don't know. I just think it's pretty thuggin'. It's cool.
Yeah,
it's cool when you tag that shit. Posh God.
Being a god is dope.
It surpasses the actual... the name, you know, I don't see myself attached to that name.
Right.
You know, whether it be God or toilet, you feel me?
Should we talk? Well, okay. Should we talk about how you got that name? Where'd it come from?
I don't know, man. It could be like 30,000,000 ways to tell the story or interpret it.
Not even a real number.
You feel me? you could just talk about like, I don't know. You know, CSPG is like. Cookie Shores Posh Gang, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
So it was just like Posh Gang, Posh God, you feel me?
He just got high as fuck and got way more like,
It just worked, you feel me?
You just got way more sud.
Yeah, exactly. So, all that shit just, and it just looks good when you just tag that shit big as fuck.
Right.
You know? Just like Posh God, you feel me?
So for those who didn't catch on to what's going on here, we got Posh God from Metro Zoo and Phil from Dertbag, and then... Tubby is apparently what they call you to my left.
That's a big homie, Tub God.
Right.
Tubby.
For everybody who doesn't know Tub God.
Can we get the story on how you guys became friends? Because I'm sure a lot of people are interested to know why I'm interviewing you guys together.
Yeah. So we linked because of Tubby. Tubby came through to the store in Connecticut. And then we went to
the,
like a rack
the Dertbag store in Connecticut.
Yeah.
Okay.
In Bridgeport, 1001 Main Street.
Right.
If anyone in Connecticut trying to slide through.
Dude, there are Connecticut fans out there, I guarantee it.
Yeah.
Yo, No Jumper is international.
If you're from Connecticut or if you haven't gone there, you should slide through.
Yo, it's the arcade mall. It's
got like this glass.
Mad dope.
Yeah, the glass ceiling is fucking retarded.
Yeah, it's so nice.
It's really ill. But yeah, slide there. And cop some teas or just like meet me.
Are you guys the only like relevant streetwear brand in the rural Connecticut area?
Yeah, I guess so.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Yeah, some I have to shit on shit, everyone because there really isn't.
I'm sure there's probably kids.
I fuck with Unico.
Elvin.
Yeah.
Elvin, but he's like in his own lane. He's like.
Yeah, he's not even close.
He's not close, bro. He's like beyond that shit. He's like, it's him. He's the only one.
How far are you from New York City?
I'm an hour.
An hour outside, okay.
I kept going to the city when I was super young.
Right.
So like, I was always there when I was like 16, 17
and
shit.
Train ride is nice too.
Train ride is ill. It was cheaper back in the day too. They keep raising it.
Right.
I was homeschooled. So instead of going to school, I would be going to the city and like meeting people and stuff.
Right.
And then, I kind of like it's my second home, basically.
When did you start? When did you say that you started your clothing line? And was Dertbag the original name?
Yeah. I didn't really have a name at first, and then I was up in a hospital bed because I had a Crohn's flare.
Right.
And I came up with the name. And that was about when I was like 11, 12.
Okay.
So I've been just running with it since like 2007.
When did you first print shirts?
2007.
So what was this process like for you at the time? Like, I know it's hard for like full-grown adults to figure out how to get 50 shirts printed, but I'm imagining it was probably way harder for you as a little kid.
Yeah, I mean, I had some role models. There were like two other brands that were like screen printing shirts, and I just was like, oh, I can do this too if they're doing it.
Uh-huh.
And then I like... researched how to do it on like YouTube and stuff, and I like fucked up a bunch of times, and then I finally got it.
Okay.
And I just started printing shirts for like my homies at the skate park, and then it kind of I just kept going with it, and like I went to like a
what skate park printer. Are we talking here?
Norwalk skate park.
Norwalk, okay.
At Calf Pasture Beach.
Okay, just for the skaters and the bikers out there, I just wanted to check. So you start. Who are you influenced by that made you want to start a clothing line?
Man, Pharrell got my interest at a young age.
Okay.
Polo.
Yeah, polo. I mean, polo. Like, Connecticut style just in general. Like, seeing clothing, I was always interested in, like, dressing well. My parents, like, they were New Yorkers before they, like, moved to Connecticut, so they, like, dressed really well. They're both artists.
Right.
But getting into clothing, a brand Kultja, K-U-L-T-J-A-H, Kultja, they were, like, hand-dyeing tees, and they were, like, hand-screen printing tees, and they had, like, a little boutique. This back like 2007 and like below, like they started like in the 90s, like just doing like pop-ups and like trade shows and stuff.
Okay.
And the dude Jermaine, I just went to like the store one day in like 2006 when I was like in sixth grade, copped some shoes and like a tee, and I just like fell in love with it, and I just wanted to like pursue like what they did, but like in my own way.
Were you an internet kid early on as well?
Yeah. I mean, I grew up on the internet. Like, I've had a computer all my life.
Right.
I was, like, on forums and stuff.
Did you want to start a clothing line before you knew about, like, streetwear?
I was more interested in, like, filming skateboarding and, like, taking photos and stuff like
that. Oh, so did you conceive of it as being a skate brand, essentially, in the very beginning?
Yeah, very beginning.
Do you still consider yourself to have ties to that, or is it more of a separate thing
There's
now?
There's influence, yeah.
Influence, but you don't have, like, an actual skate team? You guys don't go down that road?
No, not anymore.
That's dope. So at what age did you start the store?
When I graduated high school, so okay. 18.
So you had that for about 3 years?
Yeah, now, yeah.
Damn, it's crazy. Is it tough having a store like that in that kind of area?
I mean, there's not a lot of foot traffic, but right. My stuff's mainly online anyway.
Right.
It's cool. I like having a place to like create, like have people come through. There is like a little community of like people that like come out.
Right.
That like I take photos of, and like the homies, like they make music or like they're artists. So it's like a small knit family basically in Bridgeport that like I can go to the store and I know one of them are going to like come through.
Right.
And we just kick it.
That's dope. All right. So can we go back in time now to like what it was like when you guys first met? Although I guess we got to go back in time with you too. Can you talk about the beginning of Metro Zoo? I feel like this is kind of like selling it short by having you talk about it when there's a lot of different people involved and this is like a two-person interview. But yeah. You want to give us kind of like, yeah, it seems like a lot to like talk about. It would be like me being like
describe Wu-Tang.
Yeah, hey, 50 Cent, sup with G-Unit? What's that?
Tell us the whole story.
Give the Wikipedia version.
You've got 60 seconds. Give me the whole story. What's Metro Zoo? Version. Nah, I mean, give me,
yo, it was dope. It's just the homies, Lofty, you feel me? Posh and Not, Ruben Slick, Free Slick, you feel me?
Okay.
We all get down and make, you know, dope-ass shit.
And this is coming out of where? Like, where was the scene of the crime when this all started to come together?
Miami, yo.
Okay. And you guys were what age?
Shit, since we were, like, 13, like sixth grade type shit.
So you guys always just were working on shit together?
Nah, we linked up like when we were mad young, and then we kind of went to like, we all had like separate schools and shit. So we were all like basically just like always linking up, you know?
Uh-huh.
Like in Lofty and Slick, they went to military school, so they dipped. So we'd always just keep linking up and like exchanging like music or art and shit.
But you guys were making art from the very beginning?
Yeah. We didn't know like what the fuck this shit was called or anything.
Right.
It was just like you just linked up with your homies and you just made shit in the back of the classroom.
Right.
You know, like Robbie used to make beats and bring them shits into class and like people would just be freestyling and shit.
Were there any like rappers in particular that you guys were stoked on at that time?
Yo, I think we just heard the 50 Cent and the Game. Hate or Love It and shit.
Oh, wow. That's a good place to start. Like, that's a great song.
Yeah, that was like, it's like that era, you feel me?
Right.
Like,
right before
Eminem
Game split off from G-Unit. Yeah. Shit.
Like, Hell 3-6 Mafia, you feel me? We were listening to all that shit. But like, that time, I don't know, it was cool as fuck. I don't know. But we just like, I don't know, we were listening to a lot of like, even like Lil Jon and shit, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Like Mad Down South shit, because that's what they used to be playing.
I seen
Lil
Jon without glasses, yo. It's crazy.
Rare. Right.
So rare. Crazy. You feel me? All that shit. Crazy.
When do you consider Metro Zoo to really have sort of had their moment where it like actually emerged as like a somewhat finalized product?
You know, I don't think that shit really is a product, you feel me?
Uh huh.
I think it's like, it's like a universe, you feel me?
Right, that you kind of indulge yourself in.
Yeah, I don't think it's even a genre, because it's like, it's cyberpunk, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you know, is very different, you feel me?
Instead of that experience of like you get that album after a couple of years with an artist and you sit down and you study every track, it's more like every couple of weeks or every week you got something new to fuck with and something.
Yeah, man. I mean, I drop like, you know, like I drop mad tapes, Lofty drops mad tapes, Slick would be dropping mad tapes. We work on mad albums and shit. You know, like we help, like, you know what I'm saying, like me and Poshnod and Lofty, we help like Denzel and shit put together his record and shit. You know what I'm saying? We always come together from, like, I don't know, doing different shit, just not even, like, Metro Zoo shit. You feel
right.
me? It's just, like, all the homies.
But then you guys always manage to, like, find a way to meet to work
exactly.
together or what?
Exactly. That's why it was crazy. Like, we went to the Pink House and shit, and it was, like, the last time before, like, you know, Slick, you know, whatever.
Right.
So, like, it was just crazy, like, to have everybody... like all of us like in the same spot,
uh-huh.
you know, like, you know, it's crazy. It's
but was
crazy
that
shit.
Was that rare at that time, or was it to have
yeah,
everybody
because,
in the same
you know,
spot?
Yeah, we'd be traveling and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, we'd be doing shit. We'd be doing shows and sliding and traveling. You feel me?
Right.
Vibing and shit. So it's, you know, it's not like, you feel me, having four motherfuckers, not just like together all the time. You feel
yeah,
me?
Yeah.
You know
well,
I mean?
it's different as you get older. You got more you know, earthly
you know
concerns. Yeah.
Yeah, bro. Like, you know, we'd be traveling and shit. Lofty said, "You going to Tokyo? You feel me? Bradley's in Europe right now with Denzel. I'm in LA.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's like
so. When Slick gets out, is it going to be like a very concerted effort from everybody? Like we
oh,
got to all
yeah.
get in
We're
the same place and do
like,
shit.
Mad albums, because I'm sure he misses it.
Right.
Not even be able to do it.
How long has he been gone now?
It was like a year. His birthday just passed, yo.
Okay.
So
and you're expecting him to get out pretty soon?
Yeah, man. I have faith. You know." I think he'll be out soon.
Nice. Can you talk about what he went in for in the first place?
I don't even know, yo.
Yeah?
So
nobody knows? Or is that just kind of the official story?
No, I don't. I genuinely don't even know.
So there's
it's not really something like I even wanted to talk to him about. I was just
right.
like, well, what you did, whatever you did, you're here. Just, you know, stay positive. You
so,
feel me?
But there's a YouTube video that kind of, you know, implies that he's in there for a armed robbery of like a store. Do you know
Damn.
That there's any truth to that?
I don't know, yo.
You don't
Hopefully
know.
Not. You feel me?
Posh God pleading the fifth.
You feel me? I don't know, yo.
Yeah, okay. Well, hey, I mean, I hope he gets out. I hope that we're able to. I want to be a part of it. I want him to get out and just
yo,
fucking.
Yo, me too, yo. I
yeah.
was actually mad hyped because, you know, I heard about the show. And I heard mad people were talking about Slick, and you were like, yo, who is this? Ruben Slick. You feel me?
So, nah, I think I knew. I always knew, but I was just like, I knew about Metro Zoo as a whole. I remember somebody tweeting
yo,
at me, telling me to fuck off
him,
at
yo,
one point.
If you met him, yo, you guys would be homies.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
He's just funny as fuck.
Powerful person, yo. He's just very funny, like.
Right.
Not straight
know.
Up, it's crazy. Like, if
I
you met him once, and it was like that.
If you yo, had growing the, up with Ruben, yo, he's like the funniest motherfucker, yo.
Right.
It's
so
like
is,
this shit,
would yo. You consider him kind of like the head of the clique? Like the
yo, he definitely put me on much game.
Okay.
Feel me? Swag
he's
me
the
out
oldest,
when I needed,
right?
You feel me?
He's the oldest,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he was like a grade older than us. Than
okay.
me when I was in school with Robbie. So, like, with Lofty, you feel me? So, it was always cool. He was always giving us mad game and shit.
Right.
Cool ass shit, you feel me?
You need that leader figure, you know, in the
yeah,
collective
like
or whatever.
Older, you feel me? So he just knew some cool shit.
But you guys always dressing weird and just being weird
you know,
ass people
really
from early on?
I think it was weird. I think it was more like we just was like, fuck it, yo.
Just did, really didn't
just
care.
Just like, fuck it, yo. Like, I don't really give a fuck. Like, I'm going to dress fresh, you know? I'm going to skate in Gucci's.
Right.
Because it's fun.
You had Gucci
and
shoes when you were in elementary school?
No, like in... Like, probably when I was, like, 18 or 19.
How'd you come up on those?
Because I got into college, like, first month of college, and I was, like, the books were mad expensive, yo. They gave me mad guap, because I got a scholarship. I was, like, pretty smart, you feel me?
Yeah,
boy, man. Boy, got me grades, you feel me? So they gave me all this guap, and I was, like, damn, like, this is a lot of guap. It's like, what should I do with this? And I was just, like, well... I was going to cop some fresh-ass Gucci sneakers.
Right.
Some Louis belts, a laptop.
But
started
that,
making beats in Gucci shoes, like, in campus. Like, just like, yeah.
But could you still afford the books in school?
No, I didn't buy any of the books.
What did you do? You borrow them
Bro,
from people?
I just
or?
Finessed, yo. It was swagger. I don't know. Just, like, had a homie in the class, just shared the book.
Right.
Or just, like, you know, paid hella attention.
Right.
As much attention as you can.
Wow.
But I only did one semester, yo. I was just like, fuck this shit. I don't want to go to school.
Did the Gucci sneakers pay dividends in terms of, like, vagina coming your way? Like,
you know what? It actually didn't. I don't think it did anything.
Really?
It just was, like, it was nothing, you feel me? I didn't feel any different. I was just like, yo, these are just sneakers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, so everybody's got to figure that out at some point in their life, I guess,
just
right?
Sneakers, though. It's just how you feel.
Yeah.
Like, I always felt that way before, you know? Yeah. When I got them, I didn't feel any different. I was like, man, dude.
I feel you.
You know? So that's why I just skated with them and just, like, you know, painted with them and shit.
Right.
That's what, like, happens, yo.
Yeah, because it became every day. I was like, this is every day. Yeah.
Did you listen to DS2 and hear, I just fucked your bitch in some Gucci flip-flops, and were you just like, psh, been there. Doing that.
That's, I actually want Gucci flip-flops because they look mad comfy, yo.
Right.
They're really rare.
But could they really be that much more comfortable than, like, what do you really think Gucci's doing to the flip-flops that Nike ain't doing? Like, you think that there's, like, something totally different?
I think both of them
different?
Have really cool designs.
Nike is cool. Yeah.
Nike Swish is very Nike life.
Okay.
I'm very design. Nike life.
You're pro Nike?
I'm pro Nike life.
Okay.
I don't know about Nike. I know Nike life.
What about you, Phil? Do you look at Nike like, oh, that's a dope brand still?
Yo, yeah.
Nike, it's hard to even think about them like that, right?
Really cool,
it's hard to even think of Nike as like a brand because it's this giant, all-encompassing thing that does so many different things. It's like represented in so many ways.
Now we're talking like designer talk. Designer talk.
We can do that. We can talk about everything. You got to get closer to the mic, though.
Oh, my bad, yo. I'm hella just like chilling.
No, it's cool. You should have seen Dylan Ross. He's like this.
Yeah. That sucks. That must be, can you... Hello.
Like, dude, that sounds amazing. The people at home would love that. Yeah.
Yo,
this is great. All right, so let's talk about this like infinite meeting for the like the third time that we tried to cover this. So Tubbs, tell me about this day between them and how they first became friends and Dertbag and Metro Zoo collided or whatever.
Okay, so I'm from Connecticut. I grew up there.
Okay.
But then I went to college in Miami.
He's a link for a lot of crazy stuff. Right.
And so actually I found out about Dertbag. I didn't even find out about Dertbag until after I left Connecticut, but I found out about this brand Freedmines.
Uh-huh.
Who's the shit. They're also the good company.
Shout out
in New
Kumasi
York.
And mm-hmm. Glenn.
Shout out Kumasi.
97 Allen Street.
They're like the first brand that I ever like.
Big
like,
up.
Oh shit, I need to wait up. Like something's coming out at midnight and I need to cop it. So basically, I found out about Freedmines and then like they were kind of homies with Phil and shit. And I was like, oh, he's from Connecticut and shit.
Basically,
and
Tubby just wanted to know if the rumors were true.
Yeah, the rumors were true.
What rumors?
The rumors were true and Phil's shit was dope.
It's like the rumors
so
true.
Then,
Phil got some dope shit.
I was living
shit.
In Miami just chilling with him a lot and I was a big fan of his art and Metro Zoo and everything and I was just like, yo, you gotta fuck with Phil. And then Phil came down for Art Basel in 2014?
I think end of 13.
13.
Yeah.
And, it was fun, yo.
They met in person. We had mad fun and
met,
shit.
Linked up.
Linked up, and then they've done mad Depped shit up. Since that together.
Yeah,
then we came back last year in February.
Yeah.
We linked up
but, yo, I remember the first time, it was, like, the last night, like, the last hour of the night that we made shit. Like, that was the first time.
When?
In fucking Art Basel.
Yeah.
So, what, you were actually doing art during Art Basel? This is
it's not that crazy.
It wasn't even like that.
Sounds cool to me, yeah.
It was just like on some chilling shit.
Yeah, it was just like, yo, let's make some chilling. Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, his house is mad nice to just make shit at. Like, his old crib and...
Yeah, he came to my crib like a couple months back.
Is this something you guys all do when you get together? Is you just kind of like start doing art projects together?
That
sounds dope as fuck.
I had like the art like cave pretty much. Everyone would just come through and meet up and just do mad shit.
Like art cave is like it's like basically we had these tight ass. We had these. Tubby had these tight ass like Dre speakers that we could just make mad beats, plug in aux cord, and just like
everyone would come through. Denzel would come through.
He's recording mad shit.
Shuttle Life would come through like. Everyone would come through and we just would chill all day for like
and then
chill for like a weekend, you know.
Right there.
I would just never go to class.
Yo, and his
and that's why I ended up finishing.
He
school.
Had this huge couch. That shit was so nice.
I had two big ass
couches.
Had
two big ass couches.
So would it be music and art both being created at the same time? Like everybody would
literally,
just kind of be
like,
vibing.
There'd be little sections all over.
Be like we just be making beats.
He'd
and
be
like,
painting.
Robbie would be painting, or I'll be painting and Robbie would be making beats.
Slick would be on the balcony freestyling.
Yeah, writing raps and shit.
Yeah, just. Everyone was doing shit. It was tight.
Wow, that's dope. That sounds cool as fuck. I need art friends.
It was a really good era.
Yeah, and then
we just make shit. That's the thing is like if you ever got us together, that's all we'd be doing.
I say the big difference in like Miami to LA is that like LA there's mad events. You know?
Yeah, there's always something to do. You
and
don't
like,
have to make your own.
They
fun,
have those
you know?
Two in Miami, but they're not really tight. So like we would never really go out that much unless it was one of our homie shows. You know, so we would. like every night was just like link up, do some shit, get some food, do some more shit.
Yeah, man, it was mad tight to just, you know,
yeah,
be vibing out and making shit, because at least, you know, be hella productive,
right?
You know what I'm saying? Or just not doing shit, not going out to some boring ass party.
When did Mink Rug, or was Mink Rug like the big record that all of a sudden you guys had mad attention on you?
Because
that's the one that people always talk about.
Yeah, I think like that was really big, like for what's it like? I don't know, the like spreading the internet,
right?
Spreading through the veins of the internet.
yeah. You took the fucking the needle and you shoved it in the arm of the internet and you just injected that shit. Like,
that record was the
that's just timeless, bro.
Yeah, it's very timeless.
Did you consider it a big creative leap, or did it just coincidentally happen to be the one that the internet like latched onto that went more viral?
I think so, because there's other records that came out before that I think are equivalently as good that people might not even know about.
Right.
Because they just like, they're like in this weird sector of the cyber world.
Right.
That you just can't just go and find Metro Zoo's first album, you know?
Right.
The Metro, you know, for the record, the Metro Zoo discography is like,
yeah, it's ridiculously overwhelming.
Because it's like, yo, we basically were unfiltered since Jits, you feel me?
Right.
So we had MySpace, Facebook, and what was it? That was it. Yeah, it went from MySpace and it jumped into Facebook. You feel me? But yeah.
And it's a shame too, because it's like, if SoundCloud had been around for that whole era, then all the shit would be archived on SoundCloud, all neat and orderly. But at the same time,
it's all out there, Leo.
It's all out there somewhere, yeah. Yo.
Like, do you like that though?
Somebody has it.
That there's a challenge of that, if somebody were to try to put together. Have you seen anyone try to make like a full discography of everything?
I don't know. The only full discography.
Yeah.
The full discography, I don't know.
It don't have everything. But it's funny because you see mad people like tweeting like, yo, who has this tape, like, please send me and shit.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, it's makes like, it's off, it's like really, trading that's cards. What I'm saying, it's a universe, yo.
Yeah.
And I'll show him shit from Ruben and Lofty that he's never heard in his life.
Yeah.
Right.
It's like, it's too big, you know, it's just so
much.
Yeah,
we all make so much stuff, you know.
Like, even Denzel, too. He, like, Denzel's taking a slower, like, album release.
Right. Recently,
yeah, he's doing
it. He still makes just as much. Yeah, you know?
Do you think that he has to do that in order to try to, like, become, like, a more famous rapper?
No.
He doesn't have to do anything. He's just building his brand. That's the way he wants to do it, you know?
Right.
He's always been, like, you know, very much, like, a visionary and about, like, a complete album. And he really puts, like, a year of work into an album.
It sounds crazy, you know, like, it sounds crazy, but yeah, he goes in on that shit.
And, like, that's why his shit's, like, a story when you listen to. Like, I remember the night before Nostalgic 64 came out.
Yo, we listened to it. It was so dope, yo.
And everyone was there, and we, like, played it start to finish, and that's the first time we heard it all mixed and in order and everything, and we were just like, Damn,
this is the one.
Denzel, yo, it's
really,
crazy. Like,
became a man.
Yo,
like,
not even that, yo. It's
no,
just like,
but like he leveled up. Like,
yeah, he leveled that shit up.
He
yo.
Leveled up.
You heard that shit, you were just like, oh shit.
Yeah.
Say no lo-fi ass shit.
And now he like right now he's in Europe, just sold out shows in Belgium. Sold out shows.
That good? That's dope.
Yeah, yo, he's killing it, man.
If you've never been to a show, you
got
to go.
Yo, you got to.
I haven't actually seen him live. That's a good point.
He's so good live.
It's nice.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
It's like he brings it so wild.
It's fun. You feel me? It's a good show.
Yeah. He's dope as fuck.
I've seen mad shows in my life. And that shit is a dope ass show.
He's been on so many tours now that he's like, he's really a seasoned veteran. And now he's like headlining his shit and just killing it. Like,
right.
Yeah.
Do you miss those days, that era of like, you know, Denzel and you guys and everybody, and like what was like the prime era, like 2010?
I'm not gonna lie, it was mad dope, but I don't want to say I don't miss it, because obviously you know you're gonna miss something,
yeah,
you know, whatever it may be, but like I'm really happy for where like everything is now, you know,
because
I feel like that shit was so cool,
yeah,
to like experience, but I feel like everybody's experiencing like a richer flavor of life right now. You feel me?
In the Miami scene as well, or in just your life, or everybody
in like
that,
my life
came
from that. And the homies like close to me, you feel me?
Right.
Who I like, you know, came up with and shit from Metro Zoo, C9, feel me? Everybody in the Miami, you know.
It's just everybody's just progression.
You know what I'm saying? Like that whole Miami shit, like everybody, you feel me? Like, I feel like everybody's just like, okay,
but
they know they shit now and just like,
all the
this is what we
too.
Do now, you feel me? I feel like, I don't know, it's gangster shit. Yeah. Like I said, like, I'd rather chill with Denzel now than Denzel when he was a jit. Like,
okay, really? Because, what, he had a lot of growing up to do?
Nah, bro. He was just like, he's just a million miles an hour, yo. And he's just cool as fuck. We were just like, yo, we were just like, yo, man. But you just knew, like, he was always like, yo, let's make a beat.
Right.
Yo, let's do this. Yo, let's do this shit right now. And I was like, all right, Denzel, I'm going to show you how to do this shit. Just make this shit, all right? He'd be like, all right, for sure. And then Denzel making beats and shit, you feel me?
Right.
So it was mad dope. But now he could just do that shit himself. He'd be like, yo, let's collab on some shit. Like,
right.
It feels crazy to do that shit now. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, teaching somebody figured that shit out. I was like, oh, man, it's gangster as fuck.
That's dope. Phil, do you consider Miami like your home away from home or?
Nah.
Is that your second favorite city after Connecticut or what?
Nah.
You didn't really even spend that good of a time in Miami. Because he came for Art Basel.
Uh-huh.
And Art Basel is really cool, you know? Especially for like I don't want to say especially for a foreign person because you're foreign. Mm. And it was, I feel like,
Connecticut,
it was a good
foreign,
ass time.
Yeah.
I had a good time.
It was a good ass time, straight. But it's not like you go to experience Miami by going to like Art Basel. You know, you can go to Miami, honestly, any weekend of the year.
And you get a better representation of Miami.
Yo, it's so nice. Miami's so chill, especially when there's nothing going on.
Just don't go in the summer.
See, I've been to Miami mad times, but I never ever considered going during Art Basel. You're saying that it's fucking just craziness?
No, bro, Art Basel is cool, but it's complete crazy shit.
Yeah.
It's fucking crazy.
What's
it's
it
dope.
Like
there's
being,
dope shit there.
What's it like being there, like during all that shit? What's,
I don't
what's
know.
The
I
experience
try not to
like?
Drive or go anywhere.
Just packed everywhere.
It's just so much hot, like,
you don't
traffic,
go anywhere,
yo.
Anywhere.
Like, listen, I know like you guys are like so used to traffic in LA.
Right.
But me being from Miami and like when there's traffic, yo, you're just like, yo, what is this?
Yeah.
You're just like, yo, I'm not sitting in 5 blocks and taking 20, half an hour just to, you know what I'm
yeah.
saying?
Yeah. It's a like, different standard of life in Florida, I feel like, you know?
Yeah, yo, yeah. So you get hella relaxed, so shit like that, it doesn't really faze you. It's
yeah.
nice art, though, yo.
Yeah.
Like, when I was a jit, when they first started, like, in 2006, I feel like one day I went there, like, my homies were just like, yo, it's Sunday, like, let's go, you know, fucking this area called the Design District, which wasn't even shit.
Right.
You know, and we went there, it was like, okay, cool, like, graffiti, and, like, I was like, yo, this shit is mad dope. That shit inspired me, to be honest. Shout out to Art Basel.
Right.
To be real. Because they this company called Primary Flight, shout out to Primary Flight, they like started like that whole shit in Wynwood, like getting that shit popping, like with mad people like Auger and shit,
right,
would go like write and shit, like I don't know, mad dope ass writers and shit, so, everybody from around the world.
So you don't consider it like blown out or
oh,
it
definitely is though, but it's like, I don't know, man, it's mad cool though, because
yeah,
like
yeah.
a lot of people from around the world now go to Miami and then like crazy dope shit happens, you feel me?
It's better to have this attitude rather than like the old man like grumpy ass attitude of being like, ah, fuck it, it ain't the same as it used
to
be.
I don't know,
fuck
like
this shit.
You can say, like, I don't want to ever say like, oh, it ain't the same as it used to be.
Yeah,
it's like, it is what it is, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, you know, but still, like, people like Phil would never go there. I mean, probably go there on a regular ass day.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So it's like cool that there's like a thing.
Right.
It's like, you know, there's like a thing that you go to Miami
for. It's such a big
for.
Event, though, that there's like cool shit. It's yeah. just definitely not the majority. You know?
Yo, like, it was cool. Yo, like, this, like, all right, so check it. So, Art Basel, they had this show called 3 Points.
Uh-huh.
And then they had King Krule come through.
Ooh.
And King Krule's a homie.
Yeah.
You feel me? So, I was like, yo, shout out to Art Basel, you know, because they brought out King Krule and, like, chill with King Krule in Miami, you feel me? That's super rare.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, it's like, shout out to Art Basel for doing, like, super loud, extraordinary shit for that week.
Yo, you painted a Lambo.
Yeah, you feel me?
Painted
I painted
a Lambo.
On a Lambo.
Him and Lofty. Yeah.
How'd that happen?
Yo, man.
And got paid.
Painted a Lambo.
Got paid
Art Basel,
got
bro.
Paid
that's what I'm
to
saying.
Do it.
Like, Art Basel is just crazy shit, yo.
What the fuck?
Like,
so do they come to you like knowing that you guys have a fan base or whatever, and are they like, hey, like,
yo, this
we,
was
we
like,
want you
yo,
to be involved?
Yo, this was like 2012, yo.
There's a video out there.
It's like, this is many years ago. Yeah, it was cool though. It was nice. Then we went to London after that shit. Like the day after Art Basel, we just dipped to London.
Right.
Or Paris. I don't know. I forgot which one it was.
Phil, were Metro Zoo like the first like important cosign that Dertbag got as a brand?
Nah.
I feel like it was the opposite. I feel like it felt like to me like, yo, Phil co-signing the swag.
Like swagger. Goddamn, I love a good high five mid podcast. Nah. Like I thought you were going for the high five. You're like,
yo, whatever, bro. We
turned into the dab, yeah.
Probably
DAP isn't big out here. DAP is big on the East Coast, not out here. This is the pound out here.
Oh,
yeah.
Pound.
Yeah.
Slap pound.
Yeah, that's very Euro boss.
Yeah, when you just barely touch the fingers, it's very...
It's just like, I don't know, it's weird.
You're in a gay French nightclub or something all of a sudden.
Yo, man, everybody in Europe, like, I would be, like, trying to... Like, me and Robbie just dab everybody up, you know?
Right.
But they'd be, like, formal. For,
like, all right, whatever.
Yeah, but for the homies.
I do the pound, and, like, I'm sure that you've probably been in this position before, but, like, we were at, like, a BMX jam in Argentina the other day, and I fucking had to shake so many hands that by the time I was done, I was, like, looking at my hands and just feeling like this is the grossest and dirtiest my hands have ever fucking been.
Gross.
From all these kids that like me, you know, and want to shake my hand, but then my hand is just like useless. Like I wouldn't have, you know, I felt like I needed to fucking dunk it in a tank.
You gotta
tank
get the sanitizer.
You gotta get that hand sanitizer. Especially in Argentina, yo.
It was the best feeling when I finally got to wash my hands.
Oh, that's a good feeling.
So take us through some of your early cosigns, since that's like primarily the main way that like fashion brands sort of get noticed, right?
Yeah, okay. I was making skate videos like back in the day and using Odd Future music.
Oh, okay.
And then I was like showing Tyler and Tyler liked it. And then the first time he came out to New York, or second time I like came out, met him, gave him some clothes. Mm-hmm. And that was the time when like the whole group came out. So like everyone got like a piece and
right.
Like wore it on stage.
Oh yeah.
And we did like a collaboration tee too.
And this is when Odd Future were on the top of the fucking world.
Yeah, no, this is like in the beginning before like they had shows really.
So wait, you were like 12 or 13 or something?
No. I think this was like freshman year.
Oh, okay.
So I was like 14, 15.
Right, but you were just, were you amazed when you saw like the Odd Future wave starting to happen online because it was...
Yeah, yo, Tyler's a genius, man.
Yeah, especially as a young person, like wanting to start a clothing line, it must have just seemed like, holy fuck, this is it. They're doing the right thing.
Yeah, it was mainly the beats, yo. Right. Like, I just fuck with, like, instrumental music. My dad always just used to play, like, soundtracks and stuff, so I was just, like, always, like, gravitated to, like, just, like, different types of beats. So his production really, like, drew me in.
Hell yeah.
And then,
Tyler makes some hard-ass beats, though.
That's what I'm saying.
So he does make hard-ass beats.
He was fucking with him, and then that happened. And then it kind of just, like, everyone in the crew just started fucking with it.
Right. Did you feel like there was like an explosion of sales and shit and like people paying attention to you online at that time?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
It was hella overwhelming.
Yeah, I was thinking like as a kid doing all your own shipping probably at that point, it must have been fucking crazy, right?
I didn't even have a car. My dad had to take everything to like the post office during school and shit.
Really?
And like, yeah, it was crazy.
That's dope. Was it like all of a sudden you were basically famous to like the people that you knew as a kid, you know? They probably, where you're from is pretty similar to where I'm from.
Yeah.
When you get any kind of attention or cosign, it's huge.
Yeah.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, was that trippy? Was it crazy? Like,
yeah,
because
I didn't really go to
ride?
School. Mm-hmm. So, like, I really didn't go to school. So, whenever I went, I was kind of like the Yeti because kids would be wearing my shirts in school. And, like, teachers that I didn't know, like, knew about me.
Right.
So, that was kind of trippy.
You'd stop into school from time to time?
Yeah, when I felt well.
Okay.
Or, like, when I wanted to go. I had really bad anxiety about that shit, too.
About what? Just,
like, going to school.
Because of the fact that everybody knew you?
Oh, no, not that. I don't care.
You had anxiety about what, the Crohn's disease thing?
Yeah, Crohn's just, like, is hella stressful. My mom has always been sick my whole life. Like, I grew up with her in, like, the hospital bed, so I was just, like, always, like, used to worry about her.
Right.
How
do you explain Crohn's disease to someone who doesn't really know that much about it?
Yeah, I asked him that question today,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, he did.
I was just like, you know, what is it?
I've known a bunch of people who had it over the years,
it's
but never really.
Yeah, it's not like a, you know,
people
should be aware,
disease.
Yo. Be aware.
Autoimmune.
You
know, so what, you get sick a lot? Or?
Yeah. My body's like attacking myself. I have inflammation in my intestines, in my lower intestine. So I get like stomach pains. And whatever contributes to that.
That's why we
and
got like, the KK.
Yeah, it stress like
for the Crohn's.
Induces it and stuff like that.
Okay.
So I was like kind of homeschooled. I had like a tutor that used to come sometimes.
Right. And so is this like dealing with this?
I really didn't do school. The last month of senior year, I had to like buckle down.
Right.
To like graduate.
But so is this Crohn's disease, does it mean that you're dealing with it like every week, every couple months?
I'm dealing with it every minute of my life.
Every breathing moment.
I'd be smoking and drinking a lot of ginger stuff and trying to drink a lot of water and just like watch my diet.
So smoking weed really does help with the pain a lot?
Yeah, I got a medicinal card.
Even
in
Connecticut?
Yeah.
Wow.
And then my mom, I'm her caregiver. And she like wrote a whole like sitcom about medical marijuana because she used to write for like the soaps.
Really?
Yeah, there's characters named after me and my sisters on like Days of Our Lives or As the World Turns.
Is she like actively trying to sell this or get it made?
Yeah.
Really?
It's The Grass Is Always Greener.
That's what the name of it is?
Yeah, it's on Vimeo.
Wow. Oh, it's on Vimeo.
She like got a bunch of people together and like did it herself.
Wow, I'm going to definitely check that out. You know, you got to support moms.
Yeah, no, for
real. Yo, she's mad cool.
Yeah, she's so
cool. Mom is tight.
I love my mom. Shout out my mom.
That's my plan on this podcast is to kind of like shout out everybody's moms so that if I ever run into somebody's mom somehow, they'd be like really happy to meet me.
Word.
Moms don't get a lot of credit. Word. Moms don't get shouted out
she's
that often.
She's going to love this podcast. Yeah. Yeah, bro. She loves future Birds Take a Bath.
Yo,
really?
Man,
that's her favorite track.
My mom does not know who Future is, unfortunately.
Yeah, and this is like when that tape dropped. Mm-hmm. So she's like been on Future. You know, it's not like no Dirty Sprite 2, like Ryder, you know.
I thought that I finally had something that like my family might kind of understand when Bones got on the track with Rocky. And I told like my mom and my sister, and I was like, you guys, you know ASAP Rocky, right? They're like, who? I'm like, fuck. Still not big enough. It's got to be like really big for like your family to understand. Yeah,
Katy Perry or some shit.
Your family gets like impressed by stuff that's like kind of dumb. I noticed too. Like if you were on like MTV for like 2 seconds, they'd be like really really hyped. But like if you made you know X amount of dollars from a show or like music or whatever, that they don't really have like a frame of reference. They're just not gonna believe you about that. I feel like.
They don't.
It's true.
I don't feel
nah.
Like.
My parents support me and understand everything.
Your dad's tight.
Your parents do get it. You think?
Both my parents are artists.
Well, yours is kind of easier to comprehend, too, because it's like you have a store, you have the clothes. I mean, that's physical.
I mean, everything happened for a reason. Like, I totally believe, like, everything has happened for a reason.
Right.
Like, me getting Crohn's, me, like, staying home, me just working on the brand, like, when I'm home and stuff like that.
Do you think that you wouldn't have necessarily had the time or the energy to fully devote yourself to 100%. Doing the brand if you didn't have something that was keeping you home?
100%.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, that's very interesting.
Just because, like, I got to get my mind off it
right.
somehow.
So you like, got to work on something.
I really
something.
Had to create my own world, and I feel like Dertbag is, like, a world to some extent.
Right.
Like, it's so much more than just clothes at this point. Like, one of my boys OD'd last year and, like, was cremated in one of my shirts.
Really?
So, like, it goes, I don't know. Deep. For me, it goes hella deep. And just, like, deep, the people man. That know about it, like, people from the beginning, like, my skate park homies, like, Jacques and... I mean, Jacques was mainly the one. He was like a fine artist. He was like 30 at the time, and I was like 15. And he would just pick me up, and like we would go on skate trips, film just like in parking garages, and he would paint. And he like was like, "Yo, Phil, whatever you do, just like listen to your gut and don't listen to anybody else."
Really?
And that kind of stuck with me, and that's kind of what I've been doing this whole time. I've just been going with my gut. Because I got, like, a really particular gut, yo.
Yeah, your so gut is like, what's giving you problems,
so
right?
Like, yeah, so that's bro. What I'm saying. It's, like, hella sensitive. So I just be knowing, like, what to do, yes, no. And then I'm just creative because both my parents. So shout out my parents.
Yeah. Damn, that's dope, though, that you're able to recognize the good in that. Because, like, I remember when I first started, like, my website, that was a very similar thing. Like, I had broken my leg and my fucking hand, basically. And, like, was just fucked. Couldn't ride my bike for, like, a year and a half or some shit. So I was just in the house. And I didn't really, like... At the time, it seemed so miserable. When I thought back on it years later, I was like, wow, the reason why I was able to be successful at this shit is because I was sitting in my fucking house with nothing else to do, and I didn't have a choice about it.
Word.
Yeah.
No, 100%.
It's funny how this 100%. Shit works out sometimes, huh?
For sure. The universe is so crazy, bro.
Yeah? Do you believe in any kind of, like, supernatural stuff, or are you religious at all?
Yeah, no, I mean...
Hell yeah, bro.
I do Reiki. I'm Reiki certified.
What's that mean?
Universe gangster.
Like, energy healing and stuff. Like, okay. I believe in, like, energy and, like, higher...
That shit is real,
shit.
Though,
that
bro.
That shit is so real. The universe, I believe in the universe, whatever you want to call it, is cool. But, like, I'm... Because I got... I mean, I don't know. I don't believe in God, to be honest, but...
I don't know.
There's definitely a higher being.
There's like some
and people
crazy
can call
universal
it whatever they want.
Shit.
Yeah, Posh God, what are you trying to communicate over here? You seem like you have very strong feelings about this
nah,
topic.
Bro, I totally fuck with Phil though because you know, you can't base anybody on their, you know what I'm saying? Like you can believe whatever the fuck you want, bro.
Yeah, mm-hmm. No, 100%.
It doesn't matter to me. Like you know what I'm saying? Like it doesn't affect.
Yeah,
we're still living. We're still breathing. Shit can happen whenever.
Yeah, so it's like, you know, you can be right. I could be wrong.
Right.
I can be right. You could be wrong. Right. Who the fuck is going to know?
See, like, but what he, like, I consider myself, like, a traditional atheist. But what he's saying doesn't, like, bother me or anything, because that's really, like, a different way of conceiving of sort of, like, similar things, you know? It's like...
No, it's all about perspective. Like, yeah. Whatever you want to look at or whatever you want to see.
But, like, yeah, when I hear people express, like, super traditional religious views that are just so obvious that, like, oh, you read that in a book when you were, like, five, and then your parents made you believe that for your whole life. Those are the ones that I have.
I know. There's, like, an extent to, like, I guess we were talking about...
I don't really want to talk about religion. I don't really want to talk about that shit, bro. Yo, anybody can believe what they want to believe.
True, good.
As long as you're, like, a positive about it and you just, like, want to... Believe bro. What you want to believe, whatever makes
you feel
comfortable.
As long as you don't fuck with me, bro.
Cool.
That's what I'm saying. Chilling. Yeah. As long as somebody's religious beliefs don't like hurt somebody else or like cause people to treat other people bad, then it's like
1,000.
Yeah.
1 billion.
All right. I was, So I was reading this Hypebeast interview that you had back in 2012, and it was pretty crazy that you were doing all the shipping on your own while you were still taking AP classes. Did you pursue your education after high school, or did you just let that be the end of it?
Nah, I opened a store.
As soon as you left?
As soon as I left, I was working on the store while the last month of school.
Right, so you never considered going to college or anything like that?
For my parents, I like applied, but no.
Right, that's cool.
College is whack, yo.
Yeah. So you never gave it a shot?
I did, yo. I was one semester in, yo. I got the Gucci and the laptop, bro.
Right, yeah, sorry.
But it was fucked up, though, because I was just like, I would show up to the class, do the class. I was like, this class sucks. And I would just make hella beats and not do any of the homework.
Right.
Like, I would just make beats like 4 days straight, yo, just knowing that I have to do a homework piece.
Right.
And I was like, yo, why am I even thinking about homework?
Bro, I don't even think about it.
You know what I'm saying? I was like, why am I thinking about homework? Like, I'm like, oh man, maybe I should do my homework. And I was like, no, maybe I should make more beats.
Yeah.
That's how I felt.
And I was
about
like, yo, I'm going to make more beats.
Bro.
I'm going to figure out how to use this designer
shit. I was
shit.
Getting paid. That's why. I was just like.
Yeah, yo. It was crazy. Then I had to get a job. So it was cool. But I entered at you know, Friends With You?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's dope.
Yo,
I
entered at Friends With You. They were mad cool, yo.
What did you do there?
I had to do mad rendering. It was mad
tech, rendering
yo.
Of what?
It was mad
like video stuff?
It was mad tech, yo. They were teaching me mad, like, Photoshop and Illustrator swag and, like, designer shit and draw this. And, yo, we gonna do this, so do this. You know what I'm saying? I was like, yeah, bro, I'm gonna learn this shit. But, yo, they taught me mad shit, and I was like, and they were just like, all right, maybe you should go work on whatever it is that you want to go work. I was like, hell yeah. So I just started making mad shit, then I was like, hell yeah. Got my designer game on point to release music.
Right.
You feel me? For the, like, you know what I'm saying? So it was cool shit.
Internships are way cooler than college, yo.
Yeah. That's what I was saying. I was like, yo, do I go to a... And the thing is, like, yo, I went in there totally, like, shout out to Friends With You, but they, like, they took me knowing that I didn't know shit. They were like, okay, let's see what the fuck you do. And they like... So cool.
Would you recommend that to like young kids watching this out there? Because a lot of them are always asking about college or asking for advice in that regard. Would you say that they should go for the internship thing?
I
think you should do whatever it is
that you feel you want to do.
You feel me?
Right.
Because it's like...
Whatever you want
to
do.
You know what I'm saying? Like, there's some people that might go to school and they'll use the school to go to fucking Europe or some shit.
Yeah, nah.
You know what I'm saying? There's people that get shit, they get money through school.
Right.
So
you want to be a lawyer or a doctor. It's like
you know what I'm saying?
The only
possible way. I don't know, but if you're talking about like, oh, I want to be a actor or I want to be a designer, should I go to design school? It's like, yeah, if you fucking want to do that, mm-hmm. do it. But if you really want to get into it and do it, then you got to just... Do that shit.
Yeah.
Thug that shit out and do whatever it is that you need to do to get to wherever you want to be. You feel me?
Like, I'm sure there's a lot of value to that shit. It just doesn't seem like it makes sense money-wise. Like,
money-wise? Yeah. Hell no. For school is fucking, yo, the thieves, yo.
I don't understand why you want to put yourself in debt.
That's why I didn't even want to do it. I was like, yo, this is crazy.
Before you start.
Yo, I was like, if I didn't have this money, I would have to pay this money. Are you kidding me? Like, fuck that shit.
Yeah.
Like, and I'm supposed to do this every year for like every semester or some shit.
You get sold on this lie, and then all of a sudden you're just paying that shit for another 30 years after. Yeah, it's insane that they've sold America on this fucking dream.
Yo, the thing is that there's YouTube now.
Yeah.
You feel me? I feel like so much shit gets solved by YouTube and Google.
Right.
That's like, I don't know, man. I don't know where I'm going with this. But, yo, I've learned hella shit off of Google and YouTube.
Do you
than I would going into class.
Do you? I'm sure you definitely get it. Do you guys get like a lot of kids hitting you up asking for advice, and they want to like know what you should do? Yo. Is there like a generic spiel that you give them?
No,
or what?
It's not a generic spiel, yo. I just tell them whatever the fuck I'm thinking at the time, and it's always like the same shit. It's like, yo, just fucking do what you want to do.
Just do you, bro.
Just do however it sounds like.
Life's going to be so much easier if you just be yourself.
Yeah, right.
Like 100%. My life's been so much better when I became myself.
Became myself. I was always myself, but I just never knew that I would be in a position to, like, you know what I mean? To, like, to tell you, like, yo, be yourself. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what? I don't fucking care what I think.
I get kids constantly hitting me up wanting to be an intern. And it's just rough because it's like, I don't really need an intern, and there's just so many of you that I can't imagine. Right, so
that's like a new trend.
But you know what's the difference? Yeah.
Intern trend.
But listen, but you know, the difference is like, yo, I feel like if somebody just like did it instead of asked you, like if some dude just came through was like, yo, I'm trying to like,
I'm going to just help you out.
What you need, bro.
Right.
Rather than somebody like, yo, can I please, like, you know, apply like, like, nerd as fuck. Like, nah, bro.
Yo, just check your DM. Check your DM.
Check your DM, yo.
I think what did it is that, like, all the kids who saw the Tyler Grosso podcast were like, heard him talk about, like, yeah, I messaged Yams on Facebook and told him that I would drive there right now and just become his intern. And Yams was like, okay. So then all of a sudden, every fucking kid was like, I'm going to do that exact same thing and just like hit people up. And like, that's how kids hit me up. They hit me up so directly. Like, yo, I'm going to be your intern.
Yo, people in different states. That's weird. I don't know if you get that.
Yeah, they're like, I'll move there tomorrow.
Like shit like that. Yeah. Like,
0% success rate.
It doesn't have that method.
Shit, I need that. I need people to go send my packs. All that shit.
Yo, holler at Posh God if you want an intern.
Yo,
hit his DM.
Hella burrito runs.
Rumors are true. Spoiler alert, you're mailing weed for me at the post office.
No, weed, yo. Like,
drive this.
Yo, no, take the merch.
Yeah, ship the merch.
Yo, that should be going so late, bro, because I'll be like by myself and like.
You just gotta do it, bro.
You feel me, bro?
Yeah.
Hella people always be like asking me, I'll be like, yo, it's on its way, bro.
One day.
So, you have a hard time with the shipping as well? It seems like everybody I talk to who owns a clothing line has a rough time staying on a good schedule.
I get it. I get everything trying to get pop. I don't know how Phil does it, you know?
I got mad orders, but I get back.
Are you dialed? Do you do all your own shipping still?
Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy. It's that's great. A lot of time, dude.
Girlfriend helps me sometimes, but most of the time.
I'll be busting that shit out in the crib, yo. Like,
I mean, I got like a... there's like a spare bedroom that I turned into an office. Yo, I have like everything.
Phil's crib
just
is
like
the shit, yo.
Pat down. Down pat.
Pat down. Yo. That's what they do when you go in the club. They pat you down. That's different than down pat.
Now you can go in the club and get patted that, like, down.
Yeah, is that a big deal being 21 for you?
Man, it doesn't feel any different.
It's always so anticlimactic.
Are you a drinker?
No.
So then there you go.
Stomach.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Mature beyond his years, I feel like.
Yeah, I have like an old soul. People tell me it's weird.
Yeah.
That's good though, because man, like that's the worst part of turning 21. Is like, oh, you're gonna go out with your friends and they're gonna make you get so drunk that you're gonna fucking have the worst night worst day.
We're gonna hit King Eddie's after this, though.
Shout out to King Eddie's. Great bar next door.
We're gonna hit King
Eddie's
after this next door.
It's just the bar next door. Yeah.
God,
legendary spot.
Hey, so what would happen if you like drank a shitload, like way too much?
Yo, we're going to Vegas.
You are? You're going
to
take it?
Yeah. If we drink a shitload, we're going to Vegas.
Yesterday we told him, like, we were chilling at night till like pretty late, and then he dipped and went home, and he texted us the next morning like, yo, what's up? And we're like, yo, shit got weird. We're in Vegas.
And we never texted back.
And then he was like, oh, shit. And we forgot to tell him we were kidding until like.
He's like, I'm here.
Like 3 or 4 hours later, and then we're like, oh, I was like, oh, wait, no, we're at the crib.
That would be crazy.
But wait, if you got drunk as fuck, you would just be like all bad. Like you'd probably be sick for a while after.
Yeah. I mean, not for a while. I would just be sick. I don't want to. Why would you want to be sick?
Yeah, that sounds
getting
horrible.
Drunk is not really.
I got
swagger.
Drunk, as fuck,
but you'll get sick from drinking even without Crohn's disease or without any disease. It's already horrible.
Yeah,
fucking
that's all I'm saying. Yeah.
I mean, alcohol is nice. You feel me? It's nice to have
like
a
alcohol,
beer, some shit,
yeah,
two
wine.
Beers.
Wine.
Some draft beer.
Got some Clico.
It's cold draft beer, yo. Beer. So nice.
Do we know how Crohn's disease interacts with hard Class A drugs?
How is it? When
have you not tried that yet?
Does it affect?
No.
It's ecstasy, y'all.
Never done ecstasy.
You never done any of these things?
I just like weed, man.
That's
weed's
good.
Cool. Weed comes from the ground. No synthetic. Yo, weed is shit.
The cocaine best. Comes from the ground. It just there's a lot more steps in yeah. between yo, the ground.
Shit. I ate cocaine. I ate the coca leaf in Bolivia.
You did you really? How was that?
Crazy. I ate it as a little kid, yo.
Really?
My grandma was just like, like.
But that's what they all do out there, like their day to day shit,
because
right?
It's like so high in the mountains, yo.
Yeah.
And like you need to raise your blood pressure, so you got to eat like that shit.
Because they work really so hard out there.
Yeah, yo.
Damn.
So you can but breathe when you better. Chew it, it's not as bad.
It's not like snorting a line when you chew the leaf because it's like thousands of leaves go into like a tiny little bag of coke, I think.
Yeah, yeah. You eat a lot of it though. It's like a handful. You feel me?
Yeah.
It's like you know like chewing tobacco. Or you know how you put it in your mouth and shit? Yeah.
I've seen it.
You know what I'm saying? You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, you don't, like, put it, like, you're not, like, you gotta put that shit, like, to the side. Shit. Yeah, it's like mad Indian swag.
Yeah.
It's cool shit.
But, you know, okay, think about this. I heard somebody on a podcast recently.
I never did cocaine, though, so I don't know.
Well, you're missing out. Give it a go sometime. No, I'm just kidding. This shit's bad. But, but yo, think about this. I heard somebody say on a podcast, cool. They were like, yo, Hitler was on like speed meth his entire life. That was like the point
he's
that they
crazy,
made.
Yo, I already fucked dogs.
Back in the day, I haven't heard that.
They had he was found with like dogs.
Yo, this guy that they this guy Hitler is a crazy guy.
this guy Hitler. Okay,
this guy
but
did some crazy shit.
Somebody made the point though that they were like, we don't know that like meth at that time might have like not been as powerful as it is now. And then they were like, think about like what people drink at fucking Starbucks on an average day, like. That shit is so much more powerful than anything that they would have had access to before, like, the modern age.
They used to have the pure shit, like, even Johnny Cash and shit. They used to just be popping straight, like, meth pills.
See, I don't know that much about meth, you're right. But, I mean, I wonder if it was as powerful back then as it is now.
Uppers, they were just, like,
amphetamines.
Yeah, they were just amphetamines and shit. Elvis and him, they were all just off
pills. That was the Warhol era.
Yeah,
like
they were
just
all pills, like, from the doctor. And that shit, like, they didn't even know it was bad for you, you know?
Exactly. That's so crazy to think about that there was, like, a whole time before people realized that this shit
like,
would,
like,
kill
you.
Yeah,
like, you used to have a cough, and they would just give you, like, liquid
morphine.
Well,
it's the same thing that people
shit.
Are doing now, though. They just, like...
Yeah, people get it now
taking
different
the prescription
ways.
And,
but
and they don't
now
know what
they
the
know
fuck
it's
about
bad.
It, yeah.
Now they know it's bad.
Now they know it's bad, and they're just, like, fuck.
Yeah, yo, don't take pharmaceuticals. Pharmaceuticals fucked everything up.
You were saying that one of your friends just died? Was that the reason? Something like that?
Nah, it was a heroin overdose. Don't take heroin, guys.
Yeah, don't do heroin.
No. Like New England.
Nah, my mom got overprescribed steroids, which caused her back to collapse. She has like an artificial spine.
What the fuck?
Yeah, bro.
Yo, like, don't take medicine if you don't need to. There's no reason to take that shit.
Did she have any kind of like malpractice suit after that or
we
anything?
Got one, but you never know with doctors and shit, yo.
Wow, so this was recent that this happened?
Nah, this happened when I was like. I don't even know, like, when I was a kid, like, 2002, 2003.
Wow.
Deep.
Maybe even younger.
That's crazy.
Deep,
but, yeah, don't take any pharmaceuticals if you don't need to.
Yeah, I was just going to say, though, like, us being from the East Coast, are you starting to get to the age where you're, like, a lot of people that you know are all of a sudden just dying from drugs and shit?
Definitely Connecticut. Yeah. I know, like,
Connecticut's pretty buck.
Connecticut's pretty bad. Like, I think the whole, heroin like, New
is
England, state area is pretty bad.
New Hampshire, where I'm from, is like a fucking punchline for heroin all of a sudden now. It's like,
now too.
Yeah.
I think most of it starts with pharmaceuticals.
Oh, totally, yeah. You start off on the Xanax and shit, and then they just are on heroin.
Oxycontin.
Yo, let's talk about something positive.
Yeah, bro, I can't.
Okay, like, don't do drugs. That's what we'll leave
it at.
Lil B
is a genius. Lil
B is a genius.
Young Thug's a genius.
Okay, so are they musical?
Those guys make good music.
Yeah, yo.
That's a fact.
Shout out. They inspire me to be myself.
They definitely make good turn up shit.
Was Metro Zoo super influenced by Lil B? Was that like, or was he just someone that was around at the same time as you guys?
Yo,
I feel like the internet just kind of like
very swagger though.
Yeah, he's very swag.
He's very swag.
But I feel like just everyone that was on
the doesn't even need to be said. That's just a fact.
I don't want to say like
Lil B and the bass guy.
Yeah, Lil B and the bass guy. Very swag.
That show that he sold out in L.A.
Shout
that,
out to the pack,
that got shut
the
down,
pack
that
was
right there.
Though.
Right, a half a block away from here is where Lil B's Ham on Everything show got shut down.
Wow.
And it took over the whole block. And it was like
trash
a,
talk.
Like a riot
Lil B
or
show,
something.
They had riot police and shit.
I wasn't around for it, but I heard all about it.
It was like Christmas Day, wasn't it?
Yo, it was cool that he Christmas came out party. Just at the same time. I really dig Lil B. He makes a lot of dope shit.
Yo,
he drops a lot of songs. He drops a lot of tapes, yo.
That one song.
And that one song that he made, what was it?
I don't even know.
Captain.
Yo, Keep Sagging is my favorite track by him.
That's the thing. That's like, the everyone has, like...
You could have a thousand
Lil B fans in one room, and they all could have different favorite songs.
Yeah, and they could all, like, not know the other one's favorite song because there were so many. Whose catalog's deeper, Metro Zoo or the Bass God?
I don't know.
That's the thing. Like,
Metro Zoo has four members, so
yeah, totally true. Yeah.
They
yeah.
all have hella solo tapes.
Yeah.
Lil B never really had a protege, you know. Like,
Lil B is just Lil B.
He stays solo.
Bro.
That's
he's
his
dope.
Swag.
Every Cameron has a Joel Santana. Every 50 Cent has a Lloyd Banks. Never really knew Bass God to have a junior Bass God.
He's still so young, yo. He still has so far to go.
Yeah, man. Probably he's coming. Chilling, bro. He's
probably
going to
be his son, yo.
Artiste.
He's going to have Bass God Junior.
We'll find out.
Shout out Bass God.
Yeah, shout out
Bass God. That's a fact.
Yo, for real though. Even if I said that I had more tapes than the Bass God, I still say the Bass God is dope.
Right.
Because the Bass God is fucking...
Because as you were talking, I started to think about how, like, people always give Lil B credit in the sense of, like, he created his own world. Like, he did, totally. But yeah. I feel like you guys were kind of, like, the other, like, group at the same time. It was, like, pushing that idea.
I guess, you know, it's like, you know, I don't know. There's hella different varieties of variation of everything, you feel me?
Right.
So, it can exist... In the larger,
yeah.
You know, as you know, the larger.
It's for those who know.
The bigger picture,
yeah,
you know what
yeah.
I'm saying?
It's kind of intentionally, like, tough to delve into.
Yeah, I think, but I mean, I was like when you, that shit came out, I was mad inspired by it. You can't say you're not inspired by Lil B, because it's just like.
But you were working like,
yeah, you feel me? You're just
like
you yo, have to
just
if Lil B can.
Max B, too.
You feel me, Max B?
Anybody that has a crazy work ethic, I respect and I appreciate and I look up to, usually.
Right.
Like, but when you see even, like, the recent, like, crazy albums that Future dropped and shit.
Yeah.
When he was just dropping, like, tape after tape after tape after tape.
Work ethic.
Like, that's just cool. Like, you just see a person, like, do some gangster shit.
Mm-hmm. Like,
that's like somebody winning, you know, like, the World Cup.
Yeah.
Or, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, it's just like the Super Bowl. It's like, yo, he's just dropping all that shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like...
People like consistency.
Yeah, yo, it's cool as fuck.
Like, you just gotta keep it consistent.
Especially online. That's the thing that takes a lot of people a long time to figure out, is that it's all about just consistency. Like, people always want to say quality over quantity, and that's true. But what that kind of doesn't mention is that quantity is also really, really important. You know, like,
yeah,
of course,
sure.
When it comes to the building of a fan base online, like, if you do one good thing or a couple good things, I mean, that's just not going to get you where you want to be going. You have to be able to be consistent.
Yo, that's why
you know?
I want to just, like, keep making as much music as, like, I always tell myself, like, yo, I want to make an album. I want to make an album. But, like, I feel like I just keep making hella, like, tapes and shit, whether it be B tapes or shit. And I'm just like, yo. Fuck it, like, I'm gonna drop this shit because this is how I feel. And, like, if I die or some shit, or my fucking laptop dies or some shit, like, you will never hear this shit. Like, the universe will never hear that shit.
Do you feel like you're constantly progressing? And, like, do you see that progress yourself? Is that
yeah,
what
yo.
You feed off? Is just, like, you knowing that the
yeah,
stuff
yo.
Is getting better?
It's hella reps.
Yeah.
Feel me? Hella reps. Just repping out them beats and shit. Just making more cool shit.
Right.
And experimenting, though. I think experimenting and having fun is the best shit.
You're right. Just trying new things.
Yeah, trying new things. Like, using a program and using
not being
a different,
comfortable. Like,
yeah.
Once you're comfortable, it kind of gets boring. You got to just, like,
yeah,
keep
yo.
Maneuvering and trying different stuff. And,
but
like, trying
new places.
So, is that tough for you running a clothing line? Because you're sort of expected to do, like, a very similar thing every season.
I'm not really expected to do anything. I'm kind of just living my life. And as I live my life, I design and... Things happen for a reason, like I said before, and I'm just trying to progress with the clothing thing. Like, I'm trying to do more cut and sew stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like my designs are up to par. I'm just sitting on a bunch of stuff, so.
Is doing cut and sew a huge challenge for you in terms of just working with people?
Nah, I just dropped off a shirt that I want to get patterned.
Right.
And the lady's supposed to get the sample done before I leave tomorrow.
Right. Hell yeah.
And then it's going to be, like, production and stuff. But, man, I'm just trying to make more stuff. I'm trying to just hit all creative outlets.
Yo, this man just dropped a tape.
Yeah.
Called Younger Thug.
Yeah,
it's just
my production name is Younger Thug.
His first
so you
tape.
Just put an instrumental tape?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It's cool.
Young
Phil, like,
making beats.
Tape.
Do people online know that it's you who put it out, or is this being
the
real
ones?
Bro, they know.
The
I'm
real
linking
ones
in the
have to know.
Yeah, they know.
Ones. I'm linking in the description, so they'll know then at least.
Yeah, yo, Younger
man,
Thug.
For sure.
But it's cool. It's cool for, like, a first tape. I'm just trying to, like, it was, like, a year's worth of music that I just wanted to be, like, okay, now I can, like, move on and, like...
Who got you into making beats, him?
Him, probably. But, like, I don't know. I've always just, like, liked Pharrell's beats. And right. I liked production, Timbaland.
Yo, it's funny, like, making music, yo, you just gotta do like that shit.
Yeah, you just gotta feel it. Like, after a certain point of, like, making stuff, you just realize that, like, okay, there's no real... There's, like, a formula to, like, a certain extent, but you just gotta, like, feel it.
Right.
You just gotta be in the right, like, mindset. It's gotta be, like, a stream of consciousness. Like, that's how I design. That's how I, like, make music. That's how I do everything now. It's just, like, I gotta do it, like, one time, and then I can, like, tweak it or whatever after. But, like, it has to be that stream of consciousness because it's, like, me.
Right.
Like, I'm trying to give, like... myself when I make a piece, I'm trying to get myself when I make a song, I'm trying to get myself when I take a photo, anything, I'm trying to just be in that moment. You feel me? I feel like that's the best work, and I feel like, I don't know.
Do you have any big goals in like the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years?
Oh my god.
Trying to have a warehouse.
Uh-huh.
Man, trying to, I don't know. I have goals, yeah.
But do you want to stick with the same location in Connecticut, or could you see yourself moving to New York or something?
Man, I'm cool in Connecticut right now. I don't know in the next 5 years where I'm going to be.
I would definitely like to have a store. That'd be cool.
But yeah, having like a
dope
warehouse.
Just a dope studio. Yeah, like a warehouse.
I just want to like...
You can just make shit at.
I don't know.
Send that shit.
I'm content where I'm at now. But for the next 5 years, I'm just trying to expand in every way. I'm trying to get more people into it. But I'm trying to just, like, I don't know, it's a social experiment, yo.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make a hard ass anime.
Like, maybe in the next five years, I'm, like, over, like, designing, and I'm trying to just do, like, clothing or, I don't know. Maybe I want to make dresses one day.
Could you
see yourself? I don't want there to be, like, just, like, a limit on the clothing. Like, I know I'm known for the clothing, but, like, I don't know. I feel like there's much more to me than just, like, the clothing and stuff, and I feel like, I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, you're still super young. There's definitely a lot of challenges that you could take on. And it's just the fact that this is still the same project that you've been working on for, like, almost 10 years or whatever.
That's what I'm saying. And, like, the payoff that I'm receiving now, like, I just sent some shit to Vogue. Like, I'm in Dover Street now.
Really?
Like, crazy shit that I would never have thought. It's got to be a flex. Yeah.
Flex.
Just one time. Just because it's my birthday.
Hey.
It's a birthday. You got to flex. Damn, that's actually a really cool thing to be doing a podcast on your birthday.
That's 21st birthday,
too. Yeah, and so that is extra fucking crazy.
Any
that's
other
true,
birthdays,
yeah.
Like, fuck
it's like
you.
Whatever.
Sometimes we have epic moments on here. It's something, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
That cat is amazing.
That's a cool cat, right? Follow at IamTonyCat on Instagram. He has 17,000 followers. A very famous cat,
damn.
Yeah. I've been posting a picture of him like once a week or so for like 5 years.
Yo, I want to get featured.
Do people DM the cat?
Tommy's cat.
I looked at it the other day and there was like 3 DMs. Yeah.
I'm always Instagram. I'm always curious. Yo,
what are you guys saying?
Tough guys, you're an amazing art director, bro. I'm just curious because like I work in a lot of social media shit. And you see some weird DMs, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering what kind of weird DMs a cat account would get.
Imagine somebody hitting up the cat and just being like, "Yo, I wanna fuck you."
Exactly. I was expecting.
Who is your owner?
That.
I'm gonna bang you.
I was expecting to hear that. Or like, yo, like trying to arrange cat play dates or some shit.
That actually could happen, and that could be really cool. Damn, that's like
cat
hangout play date website, yeah. Like for people to meet each other.
Whoa.
Like, you know?
Like cat Airbnb. You're like
yeah.
Tinder, but
whoa.
You gotta bring your cat.
Yeah.
Yo, this conversation's got weird.
No, but that's like a very like Metro Zoo idea to me. Like Metro Zoo cat hangout play fair.
Bro, but the thing is that I would totally love to have a little place where all the cats can just chill. And you can
bubble,
listen to records.
Bubbles
from
the
trailer
park boy. This is
yo,
Bubbles
shit,
over here.
That shit sounds so
yo,
dope. You
Chris,
feel me?
I fuck with you. Dogs
what's it called? Kitty Land?
The
one
that
he starts
with
the show?
I wouldn't call it kitty. I would just call it. Yo, I would just look in the Japanese book and just take a name. Just call like and it's just like that's where the cats chill.
Yeah.
Cause yo, they'd be like, you know what I'm saying? Put some comics in that bitch.
Imagine like samples. People bringing in their cat to go to like a cat
there's
academy that they can't even pronounce the name of it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It could be nice, you feel me? You could meet weird people. You know, nice people and shit.
Where do you see yourself from like a clothing designer perspective? Because you make stuff, but you don't. Do you consider yourself to be like a serious brand or?
Yo, I am a very serious brand. I have a very serious brand. But I think, you know, I see myself as an artist.
Right.
Before I see myself as a brand, you know, I am me. Right. So, but like, as far as clothes and shit goes, I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I make that shit. You
right.
Feel me? I make clothes. You know, I make t-shirts. I make that shit. Is it a brand? Like, yeah, it's like CSPG brand. Mm-hmm. You feel me? It's like, that's just what I'm always going to be repping. You feel me?
It's just like part of the overall like art project that is your life.
Yeah.
Is that accurate?
Yeah.
Life, the clothes are like art pieces pretty much. Yo,
like, and they just happen to be the one part of it that's kind of easy to make money off of as opposed to like everything else.
I mean, to be honest, like clothes, it's not just clothes, you feel me? It'd be like clothes, music, you know, producing physical items that people can like touch and shit, you feel me? People can represent, you know, they can, you know, I don't know.
You make that hat?
This hat, yeah, I actually made it in the store, but I didn't make this design though.
Oh,
but
okay.
I assembled the swagger though.
Art
directed.
That hat has gotten like literally 20 compliments.
Yo,
in the past
it's
2 days.
It's really cool.
Yeah, and like true. 18 of them were from fine ass girls. Like,
yeah,
that's what I'm
saying. I was just chilling.
It's interesting.
Me? People were just like, "Yo, nice hat." And I was like, "Thanks, yo."
You want to get laid in the modern age? There's something about a pink dad cap that's just gonna
get
you
know,
there.
No, I don't know, man. I don't really like. You feel me?
I
just be chilling.
Too.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just a nice dog.
It's just nice. Like the lady called it a boob dog.
Boob dog.
Boob dog. Why?
Yeah, well, like she was talking to us, she's like, "Oh, that's the boob dog," like, you know, and we were like, "Yeah," and then we had no idea what she
what
was
say.
Talking about.
Boob dog. That's just a gross name, boob dog. It makes you think
I
about
know.
A dog that got like fake tits. That
just,
shouldn't happen.
Or like, I thought it was like boobs in the eyes.
She was like, "It's you know the boob dog you draw."
That's
when
what
you're
I thought
young.
She was saying.
And we were like, "Yeah."
Hashtag, I just was like, "Yeah, I just want to get my."
Hey, if you've watched this podcast up to this point, tweet hashtag boob dog,
yeah,
and then we
dog.
Can see how many people got this far.
Yeah.
That's like the ultimate like
mile
secret.
Marker.
Yeah. Mile marker
boob dog. Hashtag mile marker boob dog.
If you put both and you were really paying attention. Yeah. Hey, were you huge on Tumblr as well? Because I know he was.
I don't know how many followers I have. I'm sure I have a Tumblr page.
You
Metro
passionate.
Zoo one has a lot.
Metro Zoo has a lot. And that's usually like that's me and Robbie's Instagram, yo.
Posts on that one.
And then we just post everything from there.
Right.
Like I'm telling you, like this shit is not like it's crazy, yo. It's like a universe, yo, of something. Like, I can't even describe it, you feel me? It's not like Amazon.com.
Yeah,
know? It
yeah.
Have,
like,
it's store.
Like a, there's no destination.
Photos,
it's just everything
saying?
Littered
no,
throughout the
shit.
Internet.
It
yeah.
needs to be, though. It should be.
It'd be cool.
But
yeah.
It's, like, very... It's like a civilization,
yo.
Visually,
yo. If you think about that, yeah, it's a universe.
Yeah, yo, it's a universe because it's so hard to, like...
If you think about the cyber world,
it is, yo.
See, that kind of bothers me. Like, I've been listening to all these fucking Gucci Mane tapes for my whole life, and that there's no easy way that I could just go back and look at every single Gucci Mane song ever.
Exactly.
That's why I own every GucciManeSong.com.
Yeah, but that made you
which
a true
I've never done anything with it, but I do own it. Because
that made
I,
you
I,
a true fan, because
yeah.
like you really had to look for that shit.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
wanted to find
but
it.
But I wish that I could just go back in time and like see like a list of every verse he ever did, you know? Or sure. like I want that with every rapper.
Yeah.
Anybody I like, I want to be able to just see exactly what they have, but you can't really do that unless it's like Wikipedia with
yeah,
albums, you know?
Taste of
fun. Every artist.
It's nothing better than just like looking
finding
for new shit.
Yeah.
It's just a craving.
Rare shit.
I don't know.
Finding some rare shit on YouTube with the low views.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa. So great.
You're a big fan of the low view
shout
kind of
out
videos,
my artist,
huh?
Dolphin guys.
I be sampling shit, so like when I find this random pocket of music that is just like untouched.
Yeah.
It's just like money.
It's a special feeling when you find that dope thing that has 80 views.
Yeah, yo.
Then you just gotta lock it up, you know.
Yeah, yo. I feel like that's like I don't know. That's like really cool 2016 shit. It's like
low view count.
Low view count, yo.
Yeah.
Big view count is corny as fuck.
Yeah.
You need to delete that shit and re-upload it.
chill. Like I'm talking about like yeah, like that shit is cool, but
it's cool when you see someone with mad low. Play counts, but they've still been going hard on every song for like mad long, you know.
Because you know
that's
cool.
I was talking
that's
about
the mission.
More like fucking like you know, what's that shit called? Like sample music, like
right?
Just old school shit or
yeah.
Japanese shit or I don't know anything that has low views is like dope because it's like okay.
The hacker soundtrack.
Yeah, hacker
wow,
soundtrack.
Wow, that's crazy that you mentioned that because I just watched that the other day
we
on the plane.
Yo,
yeah.
Hackers is the shit.
We just watched. Yo,
bro.
The soundtrack is.
Yo,
great.
I think that's like one of my top. 5 movies, yo.
I can't imagine any woman ever being hotter than Angelina Jolie in that movie.
Yeah, yo, we said that was her peak, right? And then since then, it's been like
that little bob haircut of hers.
Yeah.
She had a big head.
Yeah,
she got a big head.
I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention to the diameter.
It looks
no,
big.
She looked good.
I think she looks super
maybe
hot too.
It's a wig, though, yo.
But
yeah.
Yo, I've heard this is that people, men and women, who have big heads are considered more attractive.
I know that's how it used to be in like back in the medieval times. Like big foreheads were attractive. That's why they used
young
to.
Doug says
they used to pluck their hairlines back.
Really?
Didn't he say that?
Yeah,
he did say that.
Well, I heard that Young Thug has Pringles everywhere he goes.
That's tight, yo.
That's so tight. Pringles are mad good, and that makes me happy if he actually, like, just decided, like, that's my chip. I'm sticking with it for life.
If he has one or if he's got a
I hope it's plain, even though there are a lot of good flavors.
I don't know. I'd probably rock with, like, salt and vinegar as one, but you can't have that as the only one. You get sick of it.
Right. Phil, do you have any strong thoughts on chips or crackers or anything like that?
We're talking about how Young Thug apparently always has Pringles on him.
Pringles are good, though.
Yeah, Pringles are fine.
Pringles are fire.
Doritos are nice.
Nah, not really, man.
Not a chip or a cracker
juices,
guy?
Yo.
I get juices. The young snack. Some the young school. Juice,
what's your favorite chip or cracker?
I don't know, man. I really have no preference in that shit.
You just eat whatever?
Nah, I don't try to eat that shit.
Yeah, it's bad. Not it's definitely gross.
It's just like, what am I doing?
It's not real food. It's like, definitely not real food.
I feel like chips are overrated. To be honest,
I like popcorn, Rice Krispies or popcorn. If I go to the movie theater, I'll eat popcorn. Rice Krispies are good.
People always ask me, like, what's your favorite cereal? And my answer is, like, Rice Krispies or Cheerios. I like the basic ones when I was a kid. I'd be repping that into, like, Fruit Loops.
Acai, yo. It's all about the acai.
Oh, yeah.
That's the real shit.
Do you make your own?
That was crazy.
No, you just go to the Brazilian store and buy it. They have, like, little cups.
But how much are you paying for that?
It's like $5, yo.
Really?
Yeah.
I got one down the street from here. $12.
Wow.
I didn't even bother looking at the
Brazilian store, though?
No, it's like a trendy ass, like vegan hipster organic place type thing.
You gotta go to like a Via Brazil or some shit. Like some Brazil market.
Culver City has a Brazilian name.
Yeah. You can buy like a fucking, like a gallon, like ice cream pack of acai for like $12 or some shit like that.
That's fresh. I need to get on that. You know what I'm saying?
Not no little cup.
Yeah, it's like fuck the little cup,
bro. It's a little tub. You feel me?
Yeah.
That shit is so good to eat. Like I'll be skating and you just eat that shit and just like full energy recharge.
Yeah.
Anytime.
I'm glad that I asked you guys about chips and crackers and you just took control.
Yo.
You're like fuck that. We're gonna tell you about the healthy shit.
Yo, the healthy shit is the wave, yo. Always, man.
Yeah. You gotta feel good. You gotta.
Yo, like. Good to feel good. Yo, man. Healthy shit is the way.
And drink hella water, yo.
Hella water is key.
Water, fruits.
Water, veggies, garlic, veggies, yo. Spinach.
Yo, I don't want to tell kids how to eat, but you know what I'm saying? It sounds like real nice.
Were you girls hating on spinach?
Yo,
I've never seen you eat spinach.
Oh, she said she's never seen him eat spinach. Ooh, called out. They're fighting after this, yeah.
We're going to go get some spinach right after this.
How do I make my pasta?
With spinach.
With some spinach.
Even I knew that.
That sounds like a verse, right?
Well, I remember a
yeah, like we're supposed to be like, feeling like, yo, that shit is mad deep.
That's hard. That's hard.
How I make my pasta. Spinach. That's a lyric waiting to happen.
Yo,
shit.
Run that back.
Fuck an instrumental tape. You gotta put that.
Yeah, the next one.
DJ.
Yo, he rapped on some of them, didn't you? Did you have like some like sample of your voice or some shit? Mm. Yeah, that shit was cool. I forgot which one it was.
That's what's
up. That's the first one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we just about passed the hour 15 mark. You guys, anything important that I didn't feel that long? People always say that. It feels that long for me because I'm watching the clock the whole time. But you guys got any anything we need to look out for? Anything that we need to know about?
Everything. You got to know everything.
There's no destination for Metro Zoo or for Posh God. It's just
CSPG, Big Cartel.
Google his name every single day.
Big Cartel, Posh God.
Hey, is it okay for me?
Actually, you know what? You know what you can look out for? You can look out for Metro Zoo. Spoil Trapping, the album coming soon.
And the
you look out for Imperial by Denzel Curry coming soon. Look out for the new Posh God tape coming soon.
Listen to that LA tape.
Yo, the free slick tape.
LA tape is too
fire. My LA tape just dropped.
Too fire.
Yo,
play that in the Uber. You'll get a compliment.
The Doodoo Kaka collab.
Yo, Doodoo Kaka, Posh God collab.
Shout out Matt, yo.
Yo, shout out Matt.
Is that really the name of a brand, Doodoo Kaka?
That's the homie Matt.
That's the homie Matt.
That's the best name I ever heard.
He's like the illest. Yo, like, he's got
a design that I designed when I was like 16 tatted on him.
Wow.
He's a real one.
I always love the word Kaka.
But he can like, he just, yeah.
Yo, but he does beautiful shit though, yo.
It's beautiful embroidery.
You're gonna be like, wow. He did one, yo. of like a fucking
Burberry. Show the Burberry.
Yo, he dog. Made Burberry yo. Dog. He made Louis so V Air sneakers, Force Ones, yeah. Like out of scratch.
He just wow. gets the fabric and can just make it into anything, and then can like.
Yo, Matt, you're killing it. Yeah, I told you today, but you're killing it, bro.
Push you up on games.
That sounds a lot more advanced than what I was expecting from the cucka exactly. part of the exactly. name. Yeah,
it sounds exactly. crazy, yo. Here, just scroll down to that shit.
Oh wow, look at this.
Yo, anyway, shout out to everybody that holds free slick. It down.
Free Slick.
Free Slick, Free slick. Nell. Shout free out to Low the Aladdin. Homies.
Yeah, what's up with all your friends being in jail, man? We got to free them.
Yo, you know what? Free everybody.
This shit is pretty fucking ill, actually, to be honest.
Yo. I really don't like that whole jail concept. It's so it sucks, yo.
Yeah. Jail's whack.
It's the wackest shit ever.
Yeah. If you're in the tri-state don't get caught. Area, slide
yeah, let's all agree not to go to jail.
Don't be smart.
Don't get caught.
I'm doing the best I can to stay out of jail. I'm gonna be totally honest with you guys.
Yeah. I don't even know. I've been doing good. I don't even know what. I just do good shit. You know?
That's the best way to stay out of jail. Yeah,
try not to do that shit. Try not to do that shit that makes you go to jail. You know.
Stay positive. Stay out the lockup. They're going to make you convert to Nation of Islam or some shit.
Shout out to La Reina on 7th Street.
Yeah, burrito life.
The best burrito.
Okay.
Talking about healthy, go have a burrito.
Right across the street from...
Just go get a burrito.
Right across from Tony's, yo. It's the best.
A burrito feels healthy to me. Yo. It's a bunch of food.
Their food's all fresh.
It's rice, beans, yo, and some meat.
Fresh veggies.
On a tortilla, it's not that crazy.
It's not greasy.
Nah, you just can't do it 3 times a day, you know?
Oh,
you
can. He does.
Yeah, you gotta get the breakfast.
He's been here for 2 weeks. I think he's had a burrito, every day except one.
I had Korean barbecue last night.
Well, how good is that shit?
Yo, game changer.
Oh, we went in last night.
We went in last night, yo. We all copped a table, yo. We had to sit down.
People don't know that that's the real LA experience.
If I could suggest anything to anybody... If you get anything from this podcast, go have Korean barbecue.
With your friends.
With your friends, yo.
Yeah. And go drink the Korean beer. It's mad
don't matter how much that shit costs.
You got to watch out, though, because you really will stink like Korean barbecue when you leave.
That's fine.
I went right home and I slept like a baby, yo.
Yeah. This girl told me one time, she's like, I can come over, but I was just getting Korean barbecue, so you probably don't want me to. I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? She's like, well, like it makes you smell really strong. She came over. I was like, shut the fuck up. Come over.
Well,
it really does. Like she was like,
it's like standing by a bar.
Permeated with the stench of this burning stuff. But
I'm into
that being said, she smelled pretty good.
Yeah, I'm into
it. Yeah. She smelled tasty.
Love a girl.
A girl I can eat you.
I like a girl that smells like a filthy fucking meal. Yeah.
Yo, if my girl came through smelling like Korean barbecue,
you would eat her up.
Girl, you know it's sorry.
That sounds like a rap right there.
That's another bar. That's another bar for the pasta spinach.
Oh my God.
Posh God gonna eat you like a plate of fucking dumplings.
Bulgogi.
Grr. All right, so as previously stated, Metro Zoo and Posh God's output cannot be tracked down to just one location. You're basically gonna have to Google his name every single day for the rest of your life.
Lofty, Poshnot, you feel me? Denzel, we all be reposting all the gangster shit.
Hey.
Just fuck with us, you know.
Twitter will help you skim the surface.
Yeah. The real fans are out there. They'll
they know,
shit.
Man.
They'll
they know. Just holler, you feel me?
Phil, what do the people out there need to know if they want to get in touch with you or Dertbag?
Yo, slide to the shop, 1001 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut, 06604. You could get at me on Twitter or Instagram at Philip L. Post. One L in my name, Philip.
Perfect.
One
POP.
And then Dertbag.
Young
Dertbag with the E. US.
Right.
Europe.
That's what's up. Tubbs, you got anything that you want to tell us about right now?
No promo.
No promo.
No promo, this whole thing. All right, this has been No Jumper, the coolest podcast in the world. I hope you guys
thanks,
learned
man.
Something.
Shout out to you, bro.
Thank you,
hey, this has been fun as fuck. Thanks to Tubbs for setting it up. I definitely would not have known enough to get this going on my own. I wouldn't have known that you guys were in town.
Thank you, G.
Yeah.
Thank you and to all your listeners, yo.
Yeah.
For listening this far.
Trust me, this is going to change your whole life. You're probably going to sell like 4 t-shirts because of this or something like that. It's going to be amazing.
Yo, that's
take the profits and spend it on fucking spinach and make yourself a big pasta dish despite what your lover says.
Girl,
all right. Thank you very much.
GMO.
Peace out.
Non-GMO.
Yo.
No GMO,
yo.
No GMOs.
Oh,
yeah, that's cool shit.
Fun, right?
Yo, people are going to watch that and be very, very just like, what the fuck?